Okay. In the previous class, we have started talking about the stairs, which is the vertical circulation element, the most important one, because in every project you are going to create some stairs. You have to edit these stairs. You have to edit the parts of these stairs, right? So who can tell me what are the parts of any stair that we are going to use or we are going to create? No, I'm talking about the parts of the stair itself. You are right. It's one of the constraints, the level to think about. But what are the parts of the staircase itself? Let's start from here. The tread. The riser. The flight itself, the run itself, which is the group of risers and threads. The stringers, if you are going to use the stringers. The railing. The landing is really important. What else do we have? The railing, we talked about the rail. The balusters, it's about the railing. Now we are talking about the parts of the railing. The nosing, which is a part of or an addition for the threads. And we have also the carriers. If we have a carrier under the stairs, so we have to use them, which is one of the stringers options, right? If you remember, we also have parts of each of these parts, right? For the threads, for example, we have the options for dimension. We have the options for the profile. We have the option for the nosing. For the riser, we have the thickness, we have the profile, and whatsoever. So let's remind ourselves always about these parts, and let's practice like daily or whenever we can do that, fine? Today we are going to talk about another part or another object of the vertical circulation, and it's usually used in the projects, especially in the outdoor landscaping, and you can also use it indoor, which is the ramp. The ramp is a vertical circulation element which transform you from a level to another smoothly without steps, right? So let's go for the architecture and then we are going to the ramp. Under the ramps, we will have the ability to create the same parts of the stairs. You remember the parts of the stairs or the objects that create the stairs, which is run, boundary, risers. The run is the single flight or one flight. I have seen that I have created stairs. Okay, the run and the boundary and the riser. The run is the one transforming object, or let's say the continuous flight. The boundary, which is the two sides lines, and the risers, where the ramp starts and where would it stop and start a landing or finish the ramp. Fine. So if we are going to create a run, we are going to specify the base level where the ramp starts and the top level where the ramp stops. Fine. So I want my ramp to start at level 0 and ends at level 1. Let's create it. First click, go ahead towards your ending point and click. You can now notice that I can't create longer than 12 meters, and I'm going to talk about this later. Click now here. You have a 12 meters ramp, and you have a 1 meter width ramp. Fine? I can grab this point here. So I have a 1 meter width ramp. If I click OK now, I will have the ramp created. If I go to the 3D, I will have it here with the railing. Fine. So the first method to create the ramp, just go to your level. Let's create a floor first here on the ground floor, so we can recognize where the ramp starts and where is it ending. Fine. And let's click OK. I'm going to copy this from here to there, and I'm going to align this floor here and align this floor here. Then I'm going to select this floor and put it on level 1. Fine. If I click on the 3D view, I will have it here now. So now we are going to create a ramp, and we want our ramp to start from this floor and end up with this floor. Go to your level again. I want to show this one here in halftone lines. This option to show the upper objects named underlay. If you go to the, if you are selecting nothing and go to the properties palette, you can go down underlay. I'm going to change the base option level 0, and I'm going to make the upper level level 1, and I'm going to look up. Fine. I'm going to show level 0. I'm going to create, or sorry, to change the top level to level 1 and looking up. So if I'm looking up, I will reach level 1. After or more than level 1, I will not have the ability to see. Fine. Just click apply. Now I have the floor appeared here. Okay, to show upper parts of your buildings, maybe you want to make them in hidden lines, so you have to see them, right? To make them shown here in the viewport, you can go to underlay and change the base level and the top level. I am sorry for the disconnecting. When you are changing this and telling Revit where to look, where is the orientation of your view, where is looking up here, so you will see the objects. Fine. Now I want to create another ramp. I want my ramp to start here and stop here on the other level. I'm going to create a run from this point to that point. I'm going to click on OK. Okay, sorry. If I'm showing the 2D and the 3D together and looking here, is it reaching my level? What is the wrong option about this ramp? No, I'm specifying the level. The level here is specified, level 0 to level 1. But it's not reaching here. Yes, it's the slope. But I want to say something which is really important when you are creating things in Revit. Let's now click on architecture, going to ramp, and create the ramp from here to there. Usually we work and we don't read the messages that pop ups while we are working. Just click OK. This is the message. It's the third time to show this message. I will show you it here. Fine. It says the ramp is not long enough to reach the top constraint. Change the slope or increase the length of your ramp. So there is two options to adjust. The first thing, the length of your ramp. But I want my ramp to start here and stop there. So the length is fixed. The other option to change is the slope. So I can go to edit edit type. Now I have the options of the ramp under this type. Fine. I will not talk about this now. I will go down to the slope. It's asking for the maximum slope, which is 1 divided by x. So the value here is not the slope itself. I'm going to add the value of x. So if I want my slope to be 20%, what is the value of x?
5.
If I want my slope to be 50%, for example, I want to click or to insert 2. Fine. So you are calculating 1 divided by x equals the slope. You can calculate x. Okay. And then the value of x should be added here. What if I change the value to 1 divided by 5 and click apply? Now my ramp is adjusting the height. If I click on 3, for example. By the way, I don't have these steep slopes in reality, but I'm trying to create the ramp also. Fine?
So here is 3 equal to x, right?
Yes, it's 1 divided by 3. The slope is calculated. And when you are going to add the value here, you are going to calculate what should I insert here. How to calculate that? 1 divided by x equals your slope. And usually you have shallow slopes, right? Like 1 divided by 12 is requested for the handicapped ramps, for example. 1 divided by 8 is recommended for the cars. 1 divided by 10 is recommended for the passengers, the human being passenger, right? So you can usually calculate that. If you need an exact slope for your ramp, so you have to do it here, to add it here, and then you need to adjust the maximum length that you can draw. If you remember when I was drawing the ramp, now I didn't have the ability to draw longer than 12 meter length, right? To adjust that length, if you are going to draw, for example, 50 meters ramp, so you are going to add the 50 here. So I can now draw a ramp for 50 meters and a slope 1 divided by 12, which is 8%. Fine? Clear? Okay. Now I have adjusted these two options. I can just click OK. And I'm going to draw a longer ramp. So I can go to Architecture, Ramp. I will keep the same type that I have just created. Now I can click or start here and go all the way. Sorry. I have to add 5000. Fine? Which is 50,000. I'll click OK. Now I can draw the run and start drawing. Now, if you have more than one flight, it's similar to the stairs. It will create the landing automatically. Fine? So you'll have the ability to create the, let's say, the route of your ramp, and the landings are created automatically. We can just click OK. Now you have your ramp created, and after the cut plane, it will automatically change your lines to hidden lines. Fine? Similar to the stairs, if you are going to delete any railing, you can just select the railing and delete it. Okay, let's say it again. If you want to draw a route for your ramp, you don't want a single flight ramp, more than one flight. Okay? Similar to the stairs that we have just talked about that in the previous class, have the ramp. You have edited all the options. Just click OK, run. Now, if you are drawing this part, click here to there. Then, when you start a new flight, it will generate the landing automatically. This landing. Fine. Now, I want this ramp again here. There, for example, you have the ability to draw whatever you want. And then just click OK. Go to the 3D. This one. This was the ramp that I was talking about. This is the ramp. This is the landing. This is the ramp. This is the landing, and so on. Okay? Any questions? Let's go further. Yes?
This measurement, like this 12 meters, is C measuring slanted or conducted?
The projection. Yes. It's measuring the 12 or 50 or whatsoever. The inclination, yes. Okay? Fine. Any questions now? We can proceed. If you select this ramp, let's delete these two because they are really huge. Delete. I want to create a section, and we have talked about the section mark here. We can just create the section. Then I can double click on this bubble. This is the section of this ramp. Fine. Let's talk about the properties about this slab, the ramp slab. If you are going to change the shape, you have the ability to select the thick option, that you have a certain thickness of your slab, or you can change this shape from thick to solid, which will give you a closed place under the ramp. Fine? Again, in the type, we can get it back to thick. If you have chosen this option, so you can just change the thickness, maybe 300 for the slab, and just click apply. Fine? Is it interior, exterior, or whatsoever? What is the text size? It's for annotation. I don't care about it now. The RAM material. Click on the RAM material. It's similar to any other object in Revit. You can change the material, the identity of the material, graphics, appearance, whatsoever. Let's change the graphics from having no pattern to the reinforced concrete pattern. And click OK. And click OK. We have talked about the inclination length and about the slope. Then you have only the identity data. We'll talk about it later when we are talking about tagging and these things. Just click apply then click OK. You will have the option done for you. Fine? Any questions? Okay. If you want to draw non-uniform RAM, non-uniform boundary for your RAM, so you can go to architecture, RAM, and instead of drawing a run, you can draw a boundary. The boundary will give you the ability to draw this from here to there. For example, let's say this, and let's say this. You can also draw this. Let's say this and this. Fine. Then you need risers now from here to there. If it's a one flight, so you only add a line here for the riser and another one for the end riser. If you want more than one flight, you can just draw here and draw there, for example. So it's a ramp, it's a landing, it's a ramp. Fine, it's according to your case. Let's make it a one flight and then click OK. You will have the ramp generated automatically. This is about the length or the slope. You know how to change it. So we can view this here. Usually when you are drawing these ramps, it will give you this result. Sometimes it changes and it gives errors for the railing. How to edit that? There are more than one option. You can delete the railing and redraw it, but I don't want to talk about it now. You can edit the sketch again and divide these lines to more than one segment. Slice. I have the error here, right? 1, 2, for example. You can just specify or sorry, slice more than one place. You will have better railing. If you think that you need to divide for too many segments, so don't divide that. Just delete the railing, and after the break I will talk about how to create railing. Fine? So I need another segment here. I can divide it here. It will be fixed. Fine? So you have the ability to draw the run or to draw the boundary and risers. Fine? Go ahead, guys. Please try this option.